Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking into this video today. Today's video is kind of a hybrid between a no makeup makeup and how to look put together with a minimal amount of products. It's fast, it's easy, and it's perfect for summertime, especially because there's not a lot of products on the face, so you can't really sweat them off. Also, this look you could literally wear with any lip color you want. You could put on a nude and make it look more natural, or you could throw on a bright lip. It's just perfect for summertime and it's very, very versatile. Also, I show you a bunch of different options in this video. So if you guys want to see how I got this fresh, glowy summer makeup look, then please keep on watching. Okay, so the best way to prep for a look like this is pretty much to use your favorite moisturizer, whatever that might be. I'm currently using the Ordinary moisturizer. I'll list it down below, but it's very, very affordable. It's very thick and creamy and really good for dry skin. So that's what I have on my face. But since I am extra dry, I put on a little bit of the Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. I am very out of breath, and I haven't even walked or ran. But yeah, this is the Photo Finish Primerizer, and the reason I like this for a look like this is because it's not just a primer, it's a primer and moisturizer in one. So it's not only going to prolong your makeup, it's also going to really hydrate the skin. And this is really nice because it's such a thin lotion. It feels like nothing going on the skin, and it has such wonderful, beautiful ingredients in it. This is one of my favorite makeup products ever. Okay, so we're gonna start off with so most of the products I'm using today are from Nude Sticks, and that's just because they're the best brand to go to when you want a very natural, almost a no makeup makeup look, or even if it's a more than a no makeup makeup. Their products are so beautiful, so creamy, so easy to use. You can take them with you everywhere. Everything's in like a very convenient stick form. So, and they're pretty, they're not like drugstore affordable, but they're more affordable than most brands at Sephora. And they just came out with a new product. This is the Nudies Tinted Blur Stick. This is a product that you can use as a primer, so you could use it as a pore filling primer and then put foundation on top. This is something you can touch up with throughout the day. If you get really oily, you can just like draw it onto your oily spots, rub it in, and you're good to go. Or you could use it as a skin tint, so a very light coverage across your whole face to even out your skin. That's what I'm going to be using it as today, as a skin tint. So what I like to do is just draw it on. You could use as much or as little as this as you want, depending on how much coverage you want. And this stuff is very buildable. You could, you know, put on layers and layers, and it doesn't look heavy. It just melts into the skin. And like, I like to just take my fingers and just blend it out like this. So here's a second layer I put on. If you don't like using your hands, you can use a beauty blender. You can use a brush and just kind of like stipple it on like this. And it's just going to give your skin a tiny bit of coverage, a little bit of color, and just even out the skin tone. If you have veins to cover, if you have pigmentation, this is not a foundation. It is not advertised as a foundation. So don't expect it to like really cover everything that you want on your face. It's just more to even out your skin tone. And it's the perfect look, like the perfect product for every day when you don't want to wear a lot of makeup. You want to look natural. You want to let your skin shine through. This is so good for that. So you could see that gave my skin a little bit of coverage. it evened out my skin tone quite a bit, and it's not too matte to where it looks flat. You still get a little bit of glow shining through it, which is what I love about this look. So next we're gonna go in with the highlighter. I like to do this before the blush just because I feel like it looks more natural that way. But anyways, I'm using another Nudies product. This is the Nudies All Over Face Color, and this is their illuminating ones. This is the color in Hey Honey, which is a beautiful, beautiful bronze color. What I like to do is just melt it onto my skin first so that it becomes a lot more soft, and you could see that color right there. It's very unique. It's not like the typical white champagne. It has more of a bronze to it. Oh, so pretty. And I'm just gonna take it right on the skin. We don't have a lot of product underneath, so it's you don't have to be afraid of lifting up your base. So I just kind of stipple it on like this. And I like to go on the brow bone, make this kind of a C right here. And then right here as well. So there it is. Oh, it's so pretty. And then I'm just going to take my finger and blend. You can see that gives you a beautiful, beautiful glow. So I'm gonna take the edge of the highlighter and I'm gonna go down the nose with that. Okay, next up, I'm gonna go in with another Nudies product. They come in like these illuminating sticks and then matte ones as well. This one is the color Deep Maple A. If you're Canadian, you'll really appreciate that. This color is a beautiful nude. Let me just melt some on. Oh my god, it's so pretty. That's the color of this. And I'm gonna use this not in the place where you would put your blush, but kind of along where you would put contour, a little bit higher than that. So let me just show you. You're gonna wanna put this product right here. And again, you can blend it out with your fingers, beauty blender, or a brush. I think I'm just gonna... You can see how beautifully it blends out. And I'm gonna take this upwards. And then when I have it in place like that, I'm gonna take my brush and blend out the edges. So it looks nice and seamless. Look at that color, so pretty. Okay, so you wanna bring that color right up to your temples. That's gonna make it look a lot more natural because that's the way the sun would kind of burn you. And this is the perfect color if you're my skin tone to look like you have a bit of like a natural tan or burn going on. You could build this color up more if you want to. I might do that later. I just want to see where the look takes us. I'm looking a little bit oily right now. You want to look glowy, but not oily. So we're going to set the makeup in a little bit. We're going to continue on. And what am I doing next? Right. So I want to add a little bit of definition onto my face. Not a lot, a little bit. So for this, I'm going to use my beauty blender and a flat brush. And I'm gonna go in with my LA Girl concealer. This is in the color Beautiful Bronze. So I have a little bit on my hand right there. I'm gonna take that paddle brush, get a little bit onto the tip of my paddle brush, and I'm gonna go right where we're gonna contour. This is not so much contour as it is just to add a little bit of definition to the skin. So I have it where I want it, and I'm gonna take my beauty blender now and blend upwards like this. see, that gave us a little bit more definition. Okay, now use any powder that you love. I'm going to use my Charlotte Tilbury one, even though he's shattered completely. And only powder where you feel like you really, really need to. The point of this look is to look really, really glowy, but still like in a natural way, not like where you're sweating your ass off. That's just, it's not the look we're going for today. So I'm just gonna take a little bit on a small crease brush. I like using a small brush for this because it's a lot more precise. And I'm just gonna go down pretty much the center of my face. So I'm gonna go under the eyes. And this powder is nice because it really does retain the glow. It sets everything really beautifully, but it still looks really glowy. If you're a little bit more oily, maybe go for a translucent powder. Those are a little bit better at picking up, stopping oil throughout the day. So I took that under my eyes. Also gonna take it just down the sides of my nose. Okay, so this next step is completely optional. You don't have to do it. I'm gonna take the color we used on our cheeks, which is Deep Maple. And I'm going to take out those creases, first of all. I'm going to take this on the eyes right here like that. I know it looks a little bit scary right now. And then you could use a brush for this, or again, your fingers. Fingers are usually the easiest. And I'm just going to take this and I'm going to start just blending it. So I want the most product in the crease. And then I'm just blending downwards onto the lid. And now I'm gonna use the highlighter in Hey Honey. Pick a little bit up on my finger and just throw it into the center here. For a little bit of shine and a little bit of gloss. Don't put too much on because it will crease. Okay, now I'm gonna take my Benefit Gimme Brow. You don't want your brows to be too structured for this since it's a really natural look. I'm just taking this and I'm gonna just put it through the hair. Okay, take your eyelash curler, give your eyelashes a little curl. Use your favorite mascara next. Today I'm gonna be using the Tarte's Light Camera Lashes Mascara. And you don't want to put on too much mascara because it's just going to look weird. So what I like to do is go to the base and just wiggle it and then lightly pull out. And I'm going to put a little bit down here. So the cool thing about a look like this is that you could really go in with any lip color that you want. You could go in with a dark, vampy color, it would look beautiful. You could go in with a bright red, or you could do a nude like this one right here. This is the Nude Sticks Lip Pencil in the color Sin. It's so creamy, it's so comfortable on the skin. It's a beautiful pinky nude, and it's easy to touch up throughout the day because it's so creamy. But I want to show you guys a couple of other lip options as well, so I shall be right back. This next color is definitely, definitely a favorite. This is Bite Beauty Mimosa. It's such a beautiful red with just a hint of orange in it. Perfect for summertime. And what I did with this is concentrated it in the center of my lips and then just went like that and then smudged out the edges just so that it doesn't look too harsh and it just really flows with the rest of the look. But I absolutely love this. I think it's so summery, so beautiful, so natural. Love. Let me show you guys the last lip option now. Okay, you guys, here's the last lip option, a little bit of a dark, vampy color. I love this color with this look. I feel like it really amps it up, but it's still really wearable, which is very important. So yeah, that one was the Bite Beauty Liquified Lipstick in the color Cassava. I'll list it down below. It's just a really beautiful burgundy red vampy color. I really like it, but you have to be very careful because it does get on your teeth and it does get everywhere. So when you're wearing one of these, you just have to be extra careful. Make sure you're not eating or anything like that because it will get all over. But yeah, you guys, that is the end of the video. I hope you guys really, really enjoyed it. Maybe took some inspiration. Let me know what you think. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, hit the bell beside the subscribe button so that you are notified when I upload next. And with that, I will see all of you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.